A warm breeze laces the air with the sweet scent of orange blossoms. This is the Santa Clara River Valley of Southern California. Two F-7s work their train west from home base in the community of Fillmore to Santa Paula, 10 miles away. The railroad? The movie train and recreational Fillmore and Western, operated by parent Short Line Enterprises. Located 45 miles northwest of Los Angeles, Fillmore retains the charm and appearance of a California town of the 1940s, making it a favorite destination for Hollywood production companies. Fillmore says of itself, "This is not a set. This is a town waiting for a movie." Fillmore is named for Southern Pacific Railroad General Superintendent Jerome Fillmore. The town station, built in 1887, is preserved near its original location. Oscillating headlight turned on, the engineer of the road's Alco RS32 number 4009 notches up the throttle. Outfitted for this trip with a Nathan Model M5 air horn, the former Southern Pacific road switcher eases its consist of vintage all-Pullman-built cars west. Operating a short line railroad is a never-ending maintenance job. As they say about operating helicopters, an hour in the air requires an hour in the shop. Operating a short line railroad is the same. Hours of maintenance are required, especially during Southern California's rainy season. A drought ends, and the Fillmore and Western pays the price with washouts. Every trip over the line doubles as a track inspection trip, with train and engine crews comparing notes on needed improvements.
Bad weather will take that spot out, Jim, that we just passed.
Yes, I know.
Frequent trips in the company's Fairmont Model A4 gang car are required to inspect track conditions. There's an average of 2,880 ties per mile, and many have been in place on this old branch line since the late 1920s. Nobody, including company officers, are spared the agony of track work. Needed repairs completed. Extra 100 West moves a recreational special out of Fillmore. General Motors EMD Model F7s 100 and 101 were built in March and October of 1949, respectively, for service on the Chicago and Northwestern Railroad as numbers 409 and 413. After serving on the Maryland Midland Railroad, they moved to the Fillmore and Western in 1992. They bear serial numbers 6600 and 8570. Arrival at Santa Paula sees the power being uncoupled to run around the train on an adjacent siding. A boxcar on the siding presents a minor tactical challenge, but it's handled in stride. with the power recoupled to the train, the boxcar is then returned to its original location. The Extra 101 East loads passengers for the return trip to Fillmore. As Shortline Enterprises co-owner and engineer Jim Clark checks out the 101's prime mover.
Extra 101 East, brake and release engine, you have a high ball, you made it park.
We have a high ball, 101 East.
At the stipulated time, the conductor radios Jim, and the train's eastward move begins.
We got gates. See how long they last.
Seen rain?
Like never saw.
Way over here.
Vintage diesel-powered recreational trains are fun, but the Fillmore and Western is a 17-mile-long movie set, and the star attraction is steam. Used in both recreational and movie service, this 1906 Baldwin Locomotive Works 280 is placed on the rear of a St. Patrick's Day special. It'll be the power for the return trip to Fillmore later in the day. While the venerable F7s power the westbound trip. Thank you. Upon arrival at Santa Paula, control of the train is transferred from the diesels to the steam engine. The Baldwin shoves the train west to position itself in front of this historic station. Built in the Southern Pacific Railroad shops in Sacramento in 1887, the station was transported in sections to Santa Paula, where it was reassembled at the present site. Steam is no newcomer to Santa Paula. The Southern Pacific ran four steam-powered local passenger trains on the branch until the mid-1930s. But they probably didn't leave town as dramatically as this.